binary numbers addition and subtraction, isn't it? Binary numbers addition and subtraction. Is it clear? Is there any doubt? Aparna, Aishwarya?
No.
Okay, no. Okay, sure. Now I'll be, okay, switch on your video. Okay, now I'm going to give some practice. Okay, let's recall how to add to binary numbers, how to subtract binary numbers. Okay, write the question, try that. Okay, we are going to learn how to add to binary numbers and how to subtract to binary numbers. Write the question. That day we did, just revise it. Before doing multiplication, we are going to revise it. Okay, what is the rule we have learned? What is the rule we have learned for binary addition? Recall the rules.
Zero plus zero is zero.
Very good. Zero plus zero is zero. Then, zero plus zero is zero. Then, one plus zero is
one.
Then, zero plus one is one. Isn't it? Then, one plus one.
Zero with a carry over.
Very good. Zero with a carry over one. Zero with the carry over one. Okay. And for binary subtraction, what we learned? What is one minus one?
Zero.
Zero. What is one minus zero?
One.
Then zero minus zero?
Zero.
Zero. Zero. Then zero minus one. Karthik, others keep quiet. Karthik.
One with a borrow from one.
With a borrow of one from left. With borrow of one from left. Okay? Okay, children? So now, let's learn how to multiply two binary numbers. Okay, let's learn how to multiply two binary numbers. So in multiplication also, we need the rules for addition. We'll be using the rules of addition. Okay, right on. Binary multiplication. What is 0 into 0? What will be your answer? What is 1 into 0? 1 into 0?
0.
0. 0 into 1? So 1 into 1 is 1. Okay, 1 into 1 is 1. Now, okay, now, let's check, do this one. Okay, so what is 0 into 0? It is 0. 1 into 0, binary multiplication rules. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. Now write the question. Multiply the following binary numbers. Multiply the following binary numbers. Multiply the following binary numbers and check the result. And check the result by converting them into decimal system. And check the result by converting them into decimal system. By converting them into decimal system. Yes, Shubham. Are you able to understand this one, Shubham? Binary addition, subtraction, multiplication and all. Day before yesterday you are absent. So do one thing, watch that class. Watch that video on YouTube, okay? Aditya Satyan. Okay, so the next heading, binary division. Binary division. Shubham, here we are learning binary addition. Binary means two. We are using only two digits, zero and one. Using the digits zero and one, how to add, how to subtract, how to multiply. That's what we are learning here. Okay, we are learning how to add two digits, add binary numbers, subtract, multiply. Now we are going to learn division. Division of two binary numbers. So division, again write the heading rules. The rules are as follows, children. 0 divided by 1 is 0. 1 divided by 1 is 1. Only these two rules are here. Only two rules. We are dividing by 1. Division by 0 is? Is it possible to divide a number by 0? No. Division by 0 is not defined, isn't it? So, we are dividing these numbers by only 1. No 0 in it. Is it okay? How to divide? Okay, let's start with some. Okay, listen to me. Listen to me very carefully. This is okay. Similar to the rules when we divide the numbers. Okay, division of numbers. The same procedure only we are going to use. Write down. Divide 11100 by 111. Divide 11100 by 111. And find the quotient and remainder. You are dividing and finding the quotient and remainder. Divide and find the quotient and remainder. So the number given is 11100. We are going to divide it by 111. Listen, here how many digits are here? 3 digits. So here also we will take 3 digits. If it is smaller, will you do the division the same thing? If these 3 digits are smaller, then we will take 4th digit. Is that no? How will you divide 52 by 7? Here 1 digit, so we will take 1 digit. Here it is smaller, so we will take 2 digits. Is that no? Then we will write 7 sevens are 49. Now what is the remainder? 3. The same way here, this is 3 digits. So how many times it is possible? 111, how many times it will go in this number? Is it one time? So we'll get 111. Now you subtract. So it is 0, 0, 0. Now take the number down. 0. It is not possible, so we'll put 0 here. Again, take the next number, 0. So what is the quotient here? 100. And what is the remainder? Remainder is 0. Quotient is 100 and the remainder is 0. Okay? Is it okay? Aparna, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now do the next one. 101011 by 1001 divided by 1001. See how many digits are here? In the divisor, how many digits are there? Yes? Tell me.
4.
So here also you can take 4. Is it smaller here or bigger? 1010, this is 1001. Which is it bigger or smaller? 1010, 1010, here 1001. This one, is it bigger? Is that
yes, ma'am.
Yes. So how many times it will go? Only one time. So 1001. Now subtract it. Now listen, children. 1001. What is 0 minus 1? 0 minus 1 is 1. With, you'll be subtracting this one, isn't it? So this one will become 0. Okay, with the borrow. So from here you are borrowing. So this one will become 0. So here it is 0. Here it is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. Now take the next pair down. 1. 11. It is not possible to divide. So put 0 there. Again, you take the next number down. 111. Again, not possible. Now, no other number. So, this is our quotient. The quotient is 100 and the remainder is 111. Quotient is 100 and the remainder is 111. Is it okay, Anila Mohanan?
Yes, ma'am.
Aditya, are you able to follow this one, Aditya, Satyam?
Yes, ma'am.
What about Anat, Antony?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts? No. Karthik, Aishwarya?
No, ma'am.
Shall you do the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one. One, then let me see how many zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 zeros, then 1. Divided by 1, 1, 1. 4 times 1. Divided by 1, 1, 1, 1. So how will you divide this? How to divide this? Here, how many digits are here? 4. So suppose I take 4 digits. This is 1000. This is 1000111. So which is bigger? What about 1000? This is bigger or smaller?
Smaller.
So we have to include one more digit. You have to include one more digit. Okay. Now listen, children. Listen. Okay. So we can multiply this by 1 or 0. Only these are the two numbers having. So we can multiply. This is bigger than this. So only one times it will go. So one will get 1, 1, 1, 1. Only one times. If I put 0, we'll get everything as 0. Isn't it so? Only the possible number is 1. Is it okay, Aditya? Now subtract. What is 0 minus 1?
Yes.
Okay. What is 0 minus 1? 0 minus 1 is 1 with a carry over of 1. We'll be borrowing it 1, isn't it? Again, here it is nothing there, so it will become 1. Here it will become 1. This 1 will become 0. Till you get the 1, everything will become 1. Now subtract it. What is 1 minus 1? 0. 1 minus 1? 0. 0. Now take the next 0 down. 10, which is smaller. Not possible. You put 1 0 there. Now take the next number 0 down. Again, not possible. You put 0 there. Now take the number 1. Okay, not possible. Here you have 1001, which is smaller, and no digits is left out. So this is our remainder and the quotient. So quotient is 1000, and what is the remainder? Remainder is 1001, and the remainder is 1001. Is it okay, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Anet? Anet, is it okay, Anet?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, write the next one. You have to try, children. Next one, you have to do it and give the answer. So, 8 times 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This one, we are going to divide it by 1, 1, 1. Do it. Do it and give the answer. So 3, 1, 1, 1, 1. 8 times 1, you are dividing it by 1, 1, 1. So what is the answer? Can you give the answer? Those who have finished, give the answer.
Q is equal to 100100.
Quotient is 10. Repeat the answer, Aishwarya. 10.
120. And again 120.
Two zeros. And what is the remainder?
11.
How many of you got the answer like this? Okay, very good, Anila, Mohanan. Aparna? Femina, you're doing. Okay. Femina?
Yes, ma'am.
You got the answer yes, like ma'am. This? Yes, good. Aditya, Satyan?
Ma'am, I'm doing.
Doing, okay. Karthik?
Ma'am, I got 10 less.
Here?
In quotient, yes.
Okay. What about Annette?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's try this one. Okay. Here, 3 digits. So I'll take 3 digits. One time. So 111, which is 0. Now take the next number down. 1. You will not be able to divide because it is smaller. So you put 0. Now take the next number. 1. Now again, it is smaller. You put one more 0. Now take the next number. 1. In 1 times. 1110. Now take the next number down. 1. It's smaller. Not possible. Now again, we take the next number down. Not possible. So no other number is left out. So we can stop with this. So this is the quotient and this is the remainder. Okay, it is correct. Only this much we are learning in binary. So one chapter is over with this. One chapter called number system is over. Actually, in this chapter, one more concept is there. Complex numbers, and it is deleted. This year it is deleted complex numbers. So we are learning only binary numbers this year. And tomorrow we'll be starting. Tomorrow, if you are getting period, we will start with the next chapter called logarithms. Logarithms. What you can do is, children, from the net, you can, if possible, you take the printout of it. If you keep it in your hand, you can do the calculations easily. Clark's table. From Clark's table, you can take this. Okay. And next class, I'll show it. Okay. Today, by today, we'll be completing this numbers, binary numbers. So this one unit is over. Okay. Now I'll give the next question. Do this one. Okay. So with this, I end the session now. Today's timing is over, isn't it? Okay. So in the next class, we'll be starting with the next topic, that is logarithms. If possible, if your brother or sister are having logbook, means be ready with this, or from the net you can download it. Logarithm tables are there. Okay, how to use it and all, I'll explain it. Okay, just keep the copy with you. Okay, children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.